These divers are visiting the most complex artificial reef Texas Parks and Wildlife Department has ever created. In just 1 year, thousands of fish have made this their new home. The Texas Clipper has become an ocean oasis.
Okay, guys, today's dive, as you know, is to the Texas Clipper. There are three must-see parts of this dive. The first is...
Tim O'Leary owns and operates the American Diving Center on South Padre Island. He takes sport divers out to explore the Texas Clipper, which now teems with marine life.
Texas Parks and Wildlife has taken a section of the Gulf of Mexico that was once a barren desert and created an enormous ecosystem of some 180,000 square feet of substrate to bring new life for both the fishermen and the divers. I never thought it would happen. I'm ecstatic. And for me, this is like an unbelievable dream come true for South Texas, and I'm just shocked it's in my own backyard.
Over the past 60 years, the Texas Clipper has had three very different lives. She transported troops during World War II, carried the well-to-do across the Atlantic for leisure during the 50s, and then taught maritime cadets how to command a ship. Now she will spend her fourth and final life as an artificial reef, attracting marine life, scuba divers, and anglers.
This is a world-class wreck. I want Texans and Texas to get excited.
When Texas Parks and Wildlife acquired the Clipper, they spent a year cleaning it of all hazardous materials and creating openings for water flow and wildlife. She was then towed to the location of her final home, 17 miles from South Padre Island. When the ship started to sink, not everything happened according to plan.
We spent 10 years planning this, and everything rides on the sinking. And we're going to do controlled flooding to eliminate the use of explosives to protect marine life. But by using controlled flooding, at any point in time, something could go wrong and the ship could roll over on its side or roll upside down, which would be the last thing that we want to happen. The ship started to take on water on its port side, the left side, and we assumed that the water would go across the ship to the other side, the starboard side, and equalize itself out. That wasn't the case. You know, it should be in an upright position, should be going down evenly. This was not what we had bargained for. This is not what we had planned for 10 years. As soon as the ship went down, it was obvious that it was laying on its port side. The sink plan called for controlled flooding, which would allow water to come in on both sides of the ship evenly. And as the ship took on water, the water never transferred to the starboard side, and it kept listing to port. So that as the vessel went down, it basically went down bow first. The bow hit the bottom, and then it laid on its port side on the bottom.
Hurricane Ike expected to make landfall late tonight or early tomorrow along the Texas coastline, including the possibility of...
If sinking on its side wasn't enough, just 10 months later, Hurricane Ike flanked the Texas Clipper. It's believed that the very strong currents created by the hurricane caused a crack in the stern, creating a 15-foot-wide opening in the ship.
From the perspective of being an artificial reef or marine habitat, the ship is functioning. It would be much better if it was in an upright position where most of the marine life could be up in the higher water column where there's more light. We're in early discussions on a method to upright the ship and to discuss whether this is even feasible. I've been told through consultants and other contractors, yes, it can be done. It's not a cheap thing to do. It's a little bit difficult, but it certainly can be done. It's really important to have the ship in an upright position because it was strictly designed to be a dive attraction and keep most of the diving 80 feet in shallower. That's also important for the marine life because the majority of the marine life is going to be in the higher light zone that's up around 50, 60, 70 feet or so.
South Padre Island. Now added to all the things you can do here are diving and fishing the Texas Clipper.
It's a blast, I mean, to see all the different type of fish life and the various marine life, because you never know, each dive is different. We saw a manta last time we were out here, so there's no two dives that are exactly alike. No matter how many times you do it, it's different every single time.
There will be a huge economic impact for both the town of South Padre Island and the dive shops throughout Texas, as well as the restaurants, the bars, the campgrounds, the gasoline station. The impact of the tourist dollar increase in this area will be enormous.
Here at South Padre Beach Resort, we definitely have seen a positive impact ever since the Clipper has been sunk.
The Clipper has been a great benefit to us. You know, it's bringing in divers in November and December when we've never seen them before.
Come here, fishy.
And the fishing at the Clipper.
They couldn't be better. The fish come in, and they come in, and they just keep coming in and keep coming in, and they keep they breed there. And they... this Clipper is going to be fantastic for this area. It really is.
Artificial reefs are real, real good, huh? See this fish?
Oh yeah, they're great.
Woo! Fish in Texas, baby!
The University of Texas at Brownsville, Department of Biological Sciences, is conducting a monitoring program.
Morning, everyone.
They are studying the health of the Texas Clipper as an artificial reef. David Hicks and Carlos Centropin-Rostro are the co-principal investigators. At least in this play
that they're... Our role is we have a monitoring program in which we're basically documenting the transformation of the Texas Clipper as a steel ship into a living biological reef. One aspect of our research is looking at the species that actually colonize the hull of the ship. And to document this, we are using a photographic technique. We also scrape certain areas of the ship and collect these same plants and animals and bring them back to the lab for more definite identification.
The ship is actually functioning as it is supposed to. It's becoming an artificial reef. We already start even seeing changes in the type of creatures that are moving into the neighborhood. And yes, it is working as it is supposed to be.
The Texas Clipper now rests at her new home off the South Texas coast. In her previous 60 years of life, she was a military ship, a cruise liner, and a teaching vessel. She took care of her passengers and crew and carried them to ports all around the world. Now she is an oasis for her newest passengers, the marine life of the Gulf of Mexico.
Just because it's sunk doesn't mean it's over. The ship has a whole life ahead of it. This was more than a ship. It touched so many lives. Now it'll live on as an artificial reef where it will benefit marine life and future Texans.